So when we developed the car, we focused on a lot of high energy and high tech areas, including the battery, lots of efficiency technologies, including the HVAC, which we'll talk about in a second, ride comfort and NVH, charging, connectivity, and eco-friendliness inside and out. So we've got a great combination of great technologies and features. We have a great proposition for the EV category. So let's talk about the battery. It's a state-of-the-art 27 kilowatt-hour lithium-ion polymer battery, creates 360 volts, and it's packaged neatly underneath the car. Incidentally, 27 kilowatt-hours is the energy equivalent of 8 tenths of a gallon of gasoline. So when you think about how far this car will run on that amount of energy, it's truly remarkable. And the story behind this is the energy density in the cell of the battery, which we'll talk about in a second. It's 200 watt hours per kilogram. And Anton, if you're out there, you'll note that I think Tesla is the only competitor that's a little higher than that. Anyways, what it means is that we cram a lot of energy into a small space, thus preserving the interior space of the car and extending the range. Okay, so the materials inside the battery, we're very, very proud of this. We're talking about a nickel cobalt manganese cathode, which incidentally is the same material that's used by BMW in the i3 and the same material that's going to be used in the next generation Volt. There's a carbon graphite anode, and both of these materials are bathed in a unique gel electrolyte. And our engineers have oriented the battery for a very stable degradation over time, and this will be a competitive advantage. If you've heard about what's happened to some competitors out there, the promise was X amount of range, a year later it was considerably less. Our battery is oriented toward warm climates, thermal stability, and also a stable distance to empty, meaning that while as I'm driving along, I don't want to see, oh my God, you've got 30 miles. No, no, wait, you've got 50 miles. No, no, wait, it's actually closer to 60. So because of the materials, the electrolyte, and the engineering of the battery, it's much more stable DTE, much more thermally stable. And then finally, we've got a great safety story, meaning that there's an overcharge protection device, there's also a fuse for each voltage sensing line, and there's 5 undercar cross members to support the battery and protect it from intrusion. Okay, so all of this energy drives a state-of-the-art AC synchronous permanent magnet motor. This produces a linear 210 pound-feet of torque and 109 horsepower, and again, that's more than Leaf, more than Focus. And our engineers focused on low NVH and very minimal motor wind. And this is important. You'll feel this today or hear this today when you drive the car. On acceleration, you can barely hear the motor wind. And on regen, on deceleration, again, you can barely hear the motor wind. It's a very, very important part of our quietness and refinement strategy.